Observability is a day zero problem. It's not a day one problem or a day two problem, day zero. Because having the right observability infrastructure in place is the only way operations teams can ensure that AI estate is built to scale. It's like you built a state-of-the-art roller coaster, but didn't put in place any tools to make sure it's always running properly. You're bound to have a breakdown, probably sooner than later. Which is why every organization and operations leader needs to plan for observability. It cannot be an afterthought. My name is Vikram Murali, and I'm the Vice President of Product Development in IBM Automation. In the two decades I've been leading teams on data, AI, and automation, I've learned that customers depend on reliable products that they bet their businesses on. Observability is vital to that business success. Observability and monitoring are often used interchangeably, but there's a huge difference between the two. Observability at its core is about understanding and exploring the internal state of a system or an application based on the data it produces. And that data is usually logs, metrics, and traces. It's used for deeper insights into why a system is behaving in a particular way, and it can help in root cause analysis of a problem. It's proactive, so you can take action before a problem occurs. Monitoring, on the other hand, is about getting alerts if something goes wrong with the system. For example, if predefined safety thresholds are exceeded, or if CPU usage is too high. Monitoring is typically reactive. It tells you when something is already wrong. Observability, though, tells you if something is about to go wrong and how to fix it. With the rapid speed of evolution in AI today, and with the massive increase in the amount of data being produced, observability has a more important role than ever. The current set of tools in place to observe AI processes are insufficient to keep up with the increasing demand, and the end result is a lot of technical, operational, and security debt. So, you need automated observability to streamline processes and improve operational efficiency, which gives you a better understanding of the data coming from the hundreds of tools that are out there. Plus, this lets you handle repetitive and manual tasks related to data and maintenance. Then you can remove these repetitive tasks from your high-paid talent so they can concentrate on other high-value, crucial areas of work that your business really needs. Which is why it's so vital to keep observability in mind from the very beginning of AI implementation. Leaders need to plan for observability, and it cannot be an afterthought. The right foundation is essential for a performance stack, from infrastructure all the way to application deployments. Complicating this a little is generative AI, which is everywhere right now. We are seeing an increase in its use in both application development and general operations. That means more complexity that development and ops teams have to deal with, and it makes observability even more important. From making sure expensive hardware with GPUs is used optimally to ensuring that AI models are performing in a trusted and secure way. Part of what makes it so crucial is the way that it enables resiliency. Because resilience is in a lot of customers' minds right now. A system needs to be resilient, and there are many factors that can contribute to that. But the way to show customers that their system is resilient is through observability. You can't say a system is resilient if you don't have the observability tools in place to look at it. Probably the six most important of these are observability, maintainability, usability, recoverability, scalability, and availability. It's a lot of illities, I know. We use these factors to track the operational resilience of a system, and to do this, you need to deploy the right tools, because that's what customers have come to expect, continual resilience 24/7. So how do we ensure that we have a solid observability strategy in place? Start with having a plan. It's not a question of if something will go wrong, it's a question of when. So you need to be prepared for that. The best way to prepare is to start with the right observability architecture. From the offset, you need a strategy that covers everything from infrastructure to FinOps to application management. Plan on making observability part of your stack and execute on that plan. And the tools you should consider are infrastructure, cost, application, and security observability. Having these in place will make sure you cover the entire software development lifecycle and set it up for the best possible performance without unseen costs and unpredictable outcomes. And a lot of this strategy needs to be driven by CIOs and CTOs. They're often stuck in the middle between operational teams and line of business. They want to do the right thing, but they are left with old, unoptimized tools that are just not sufficient to get the job done in the era of AI. The key for them, once again, is to set a strategy and stick to it. Teams just cannot be successful in their AI journey without the right tools and processes in place. It's the role of the CTO or CIO to set the strategy and drive it for the business. So once you know the importance of observability, once you have a plan in place for it, you need to actually implement and automate it. The best way to accomplish this is to choose a trusted partner that really knows its stuff and that has to take the time to plan and execute its own observability strategy. That way you can get a more secure, optimized, cost-effective team, and it doesn't take years to get there. You will have security and scalability that far exceed what you can get out of a homegrown system. It's a new era of AI and of Gen AI, and that requires a new level of observability starting from day zero.